So hi guys, welcome to our channel. This is Gloria Celestes, and today's episode I'm gonna share with you my long time purchase backpacks and a sling bag whenever I travel. So guys, beforehand, let me show you my sling bag and my backpack. Beforehand, guys, I'm gonna show you this safety backpack, actually a sling bag, I should say. So I'm gonna show you guys about this sling bag. So this one, it has something protection for your shoulder, and actually you can adjust this one into longer according to your shape and your size and your height. So for me, this is one of the best, and you can always put it in front of you. So at the back, you can put something here, which is actually a little bit hidden, and the material is it's so nice, and actually it's not easy to be lashes. So this one is cannot be open, not unless you pull it down and you open it. Sometimes when the thief is grabbing you, they always just gonna open it, but they could not open it, not unless they're gonna pull it down and open it. So it has 4 layers here, which is you can put everything that you want. So what I'm putting usually, guys, when I'm traveling before, is for sure I'm gonna put my flight details. So it's important, guys, for the immigration, for them to see, especially if you are from the, like, in a third world country, sometimes they are checking it, your flight details. And of course, it's so important to give your flight details, of course. And also your hotel information, because one time, guys, in Hong Kong, I was a little bit hold, because of course you are alone. I was from Philippines originally, but now I'm living in Netherlands, and I'm also a Dutch citizen. So whenever you are in a third world country, sometimes you have to give your hotel information and your flight details, so that they will not assume that you will be hiding in that country. So, and also don't forget your itinerary, guys, because these 3 papers here is so important. So actually they have a 4 ladder here, so you can put all the papers, or you can as well put in one place, just like that. So let's go on. It has a 2 zipper, actually, so you can either way you can open down, just like that. So here, guys, if you have an ID, you can put your ID here for information, or your contact details, just in case your bag will be lost. So you can put your, for example, your name, your address, and your email address, plus your mobile number. You can put your chips here, and plus the SIM cards that you're gonna put. So I always love this one, because some countries you have to have new SIM chips for you to contact the locals. So right here is I put coins here. Of course, when you are traveling, it's also nice to have coins to grab to do the pulley, especially for the card. Especially when in LA, I guess, when we arrive in LA, we have to have coins to insert there. So it's so important. And going on, we're gonna go on the other side. So on the other side, you can put your pen here. It's so important to have a pen, because in immigration, actually, you have to write your, while in the plane, you have to write your information, your immigration paper. So this one, you can put your cards if you like. Just for example, this one is my ticket in the Hong Kong, so it's actually expired for sure. You can put your card for MRT or LRT. And plus, it has a packet here, guys. So here, I'm always putting my passport. So as you can see, I have my Filipino passport and Dutch passport. So it's so important to hide your passport, that no one can grab it from you. So aside from that, guys, you can actually zip this one so that it will not totally open. So you can lock that one that way. just that way. So, and you got just a zip. And here, when you open it, we actually have a hidden pocket here. It's not so obvious pocket here on the side. So, you can put the money. It's so important, guys, that you have your money currency of the country that you are about to land. It's because it happens to me one time in Singapore that I have like money, sort of big amount, that when I was in the Universal Studio in Singapore, I could not eat something because my money is not yet exchanged. And at the time, I don't want to use the card because sometimes when in international, they charge you high pay. So that's it. So let's carry on with this bag. So PacSafe bag. So if you can see that one that is there, PacSafe bag, and the same with this one. So again, it's not sponsored. So what I like about this one, what I like this one. So actually, this one is you can lock it there. It's so hard to undo it, guys. So it's safe and it's locked. So that's the first thing. And the second thing, when you open this one, just to put your charger or anything that you can put. Actually, they have, you can put your key here or your card or something. In here, you can put your whatever you're wanting to put, and where you can put your pen. So it's just right here in a lot. To like three pockets, so it's good. And aside from that, guys, you can put your water bottle here and also in the other side. And the back is not sweaty, it doesn't make you sweaty at all. This is waterproof bag, actually has its cover. So again, this is the zipper, and you can always put the zipper locket. So if you like to lock it, no one can easily grab it, not unless you will be always noticed. So let's carry on. So here at the back, you can put your laptop, and actually it has a cover, so rain cover for your backpack. And it's a big place where you can put your things for travel. You can always put it one in your locket and adjust. It is a good buy. Guys, if you're ready to travel, just put your bag here and plus your backpack on your back. You are ready to go and ready to travel. So join with me in the next video because I'm gonna show you what you must have whenever you travel in a long haul. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell, poke the bell, and smash the bell to be updated with our life journey video. Thank you.